When I went to H Mart, I was asked to put away my phone because I was recording. I ended up picking a package of Korean pork belly, a package of mushrooms, a bundle of green onions, and some Korean red pepper flakes. For preparing the lettuce, I simply just cut the end of the bottom of the lettuce off and wash it and rinse it for a little bit. As for the green onion, I did the same thing. I cut the ends off and washed it a little bit. As an add-on for my Korean pork belly, I simply made a green onion salad, which I just roughly chopped up. Sorry for the chopping skills. I put some soy sauce in, some sesame oil in, and then I put Korean red pepper flakes, and lastly I mix it all together for a nice basic Korean green onion salad. Hello everybody, today I'll be eating Korean pork belly or Samgyeopsal. Korean pork belly is very expensive and easy to eat. It was first introduced in roughly 1950 and became very popular then because Korea was coming out of a war. They were receiving a lot of aid from the US, and during that time, meat was a delicacy and many people could not afford products like meat, like beef and chicken. So many people growing up in the 60s and 70s ate Korean pork belly. Korean has a long history, especially from Jeju Island, and it is normally eaten in funerals and weddings. There are many different cuts of meat, and no part of the pig goes to waste. There are many traditional methods of cooking Korean pork belly. However, the method I chose to do today was just on a pan on top of my stove. I know that many people in the old days used to use straws and even cook it and steam it in the ground. Now pigs have lived alongside with humans, and pigs are readily available in Asia, so it is a very common thing to eat. So, this is my Korean pork belly. I have some pork belly and some mushrooms. I have some lettuce wraps. And I also have my green onion salad, which is very popular when eating Korean pork belly. So, let's give it a try. So I'm going to take the lettuce wrap right here. Take a few pieces of Korean pork belly. You can tell that this is very crispy. It's going to be very good. Couple pieces of mushroom right here. And then some of my green onion salad right here. Roll it up. And let's give it a try. Cheers. This is very good because the lettuce is a good thing to include in this because the pork is very fatty. When I was purchasing the pork before at the Korean supermarket, I noticed that the pork belly was mostly fat, and when I was cooking it in the stove, I made sure to try to render a lot of the fat as possible. The Korean pork belly has a very nice crisp to it. I think that if the green onion salad was not there, it would be very fatty, and the vinegar cuts into the fat, which makes it easier to enjoy and eat. Currently, pigs have been for a very long time forbidden and frowned upon in the Jewish and Muslim culture. Pigs were considered an outcast and almost considered like dogs, where it's a meat that you typically don't want to eat. And now with a growing Muslim population in Korea, there are an increasing amount of systems in place that allow Korean Muslims to make sure that they're eating foods that that they can eat in their culture. Personally, I have no problem eating pig because it's delicious. I have grown up eating it. Especially since I'm Chinese, I go to the Korean butcher shop, the Chinese butcher shop, where they serve a lot of roast pig, and that is delicious because you get the nice crispy skin here. I'm just gonna make another one now, some Korean pork belly, mushroom, and some of the green onion salad again. Fold it up. This is very nice lunch right now, right before my Korean wave class starts. With some of the pieces, I get a very nice char to the pork belly, which is very nice. And it comes in contrast with the crunchiness of the lettuce wrap. I'm really enjoying this so far. This is a little bit of a different of a style that I normally eat when I go to Korean barbecue restaurants, normally when I go to a Korean barbecue restaurant, the pork belly is typically marinated for me, and it's definitely not as crunchy as this. Let's taste the Korean pork belly just by itself and see how it tastes. Definitely nice and fatty, a little bit of crunch in there. Definitely taste the pork in there. It's very good. So I typically get Korean pork belly, or just pork belly in general, when I go eat Korean barbecue. That was one of my favorite things when, during senior year of high school, me and my friends, we would drive out to Flushing. And I forgot the name of the place, but it was on Northern Boulevard, where it was very good. I'm pretty sure they changed the name now, but the Korean pork belly from there was fantastic. I really should have gotten more pickled vegetables, but this is what I really have to work with. This is fantastic so far. So now in the now people want to elevate Korean pork belly to its national food. I can definitely understand that, because, you know, throughout the 70s, 80s, Koreans grew up with pork belly, since it was a cheaper meat that was an alternative to beef, that was relatively cheap and allowed many Koreans to, you know, enjoy it. Enjoy the soju. I would have liked soju here, but I am not of age. And, you know, with that comes, you know, since there's a growing Muslim population that grows conflicting views. Next one. This is very good. I could have this every day, but if I have this every day, it wouldn't be good for my diet. These pieces of pork are very fatty, and there's a lot of fat in them. So I think it's a great meal to have once in a while, maybe once every 2 weeks. It's really good. So that's it for today, and I really enjoyed this. I look forward to having more of this, and maybe expanding my vegetable dishes more, maybe to adding some garlic, mostly garlic, some onion. It's overall very good.